Jeffrey for his root beer float.
Seven and one root beer float, too.
Man, that's too
much. Hold like that, Josh. Hey, are you using that board, man? That's a little bit high. He's going.
Cody and Ryan, anyone? Right.
Yes, they have one. But...
Oh,
good. Not cable.
Mine's in a box. No cable.
Square that.
Oh, you know what? He's having like it. So we can put it on the other tree. The other.
Yeah, there's a couple.
Okay.
Am I moving out? I'm shot.
Is it an emergency?
Already?
It has. I can run. What's up, guys?
The birds.
Oh, okay. Hey, have you been in there?
Oh, look at that guy flying.
You lead him out?
You don't know how.
Last dark three times, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, we were
waiting for the pool.
We were the first ones here, and we weren't the only ones here. That week we were here, the only eight kids.
other side.
He's going to the bottom of the pin or the...
But, you know, just remember, parents, just for us, it's the opportunity for these boys to take advantage of that. Air badges, as a matter of fact, just one of them, I should say a couple, one of them was shooting. I know we're trying to do some air badges on our own without Tockwitz. We did most of the shooting down here, doing a little more down here for us guys, but we need to do as parents, okay? So let's keep that in mind. And I'll say a little.
I would say one of the hardest requirements was that we had to swim 400 meters.
How many laps is that?
16.
Okay. You dove for a brick.
You dove for a brick. Okay. And how deep was the pool, Kevin?
10 feet.
10 feet. Wow. And was the brick heavy?
No.
Okay, but you had to go down the bottom, right? That's the point of it, obviously. All right. Good, ladies, guys. Thank you.
7 people. Uh-huh. Trent is not here. Kevin Froelich. Jeffrey Mitten. Cody Goldsmith. Jeffrey Vassapoli. Kenny Esteban. And Armando Reyes.
Kenny, what else did we do?
You have to follow the safety rules of eye and ear protection and
You have to clean a rifle, then take a written test.
Right, learn about safety, correct. Armando?
Learn different shooting positions.
Shooting positions, okay. You know what, part of this, guys, is to make sure that, hopefully the parents see it as well, is to just try and get these guys to speak up so you guys can all hear them. So that's kind of part of what we're doing here. So, congratulations, boys. Sit down, please.
Make a chart of how to take care of our dog, how much it costs to feed the dog, what we had to do to keep it healthy, keep it fit and top shape, how to take care of a dog, basically.
Okay, I need that down here, that's good. And the other was geology?
Geology, we learned about Earth, how there volcanoes occur and how earthquakes occur. And different types of rocks and what the ship's made of, and like which rocks more powerful than others.
Quiet, hey guys, quiet one up here, technical base. Okay, very good, thank you.
Indian lore, Armando Reyes.
Holy moly.
And for swimming, Kenny Esteban. For camping, we have Cody Goldsmith. He also learned archery, also for camping, me.
Alright. Camping, that's a good one. Okay.
All right. Well, the Heart of Merit badges that you required, environmental science, we have four people. Jeffrey Vassipoli, Kenny Esteban, Brian Luer, and Jeffrey Minton.
Wow, these are the guys who are writing on the long one. That's nice. Congratulations, sir. Can you appear again? Wait.
Tell everybody else.
Three of them, just like that. All right, that's what I like to see. Two of them, three of them, something like that, huh? Tell us. You're talking, go ahead.
Well, I originally tried to get this badge, I think, about 2 years ago, I think. It was not three.
It wasn't.
Anyway, I had already had a major advantage over these guys. I had about like 80% of the badge done by the time I decided to retry it, so there's, I guess, not really much I can say than what these guys can say, because they went through the whole batch. I did, but it was just such a long lapse.
Okay. Jeffrey?
I made a biosphere.
A biosphere? Out of what?
A bottle?
Okay. Tell me more about the biosphere.
You put a bee in it?
Yeah. Why? What was it supposed to do? And how? What did you have to cover it? Did you put it in an open bottle? What did you do?
Covered bottle.
You covered the bottle. Okay. So why did it live in the covered bottle?
It did.
Okay. Why was it supposed to live in the covered bottle? You know. Come on. You know.
Did you learn anything?
You know. Come on. You gotta tell us. Why was it supposed to live in open bottle? In the bottle. Covered bottle.
The air
made by what? A plant. Did you put a plant in a bottle?
Yeah.
Okay. So you put a plant in there and an animal. You're supposed to live, right? Okay. Kenny, what else did you guys do?
You have to get like a plastic bottle, then you have to fill dirt in with the plant, and you have to go and capture two insects.
Okay. And they were supposed to live, right? Did your insects live?
No, they just died out.
Jeffrey? How many is it? How many words?
100
words, okay. Jeffrey?
We had to get two pieces of sticky paper to see how clean or dirty our atmosphere was. We would put one sticky paper in like an area where it was very busy and the other one where there's hardly anyone there, and then we would compare to see how like a busier population makes more pollution than a small village.
Was there a difference on the papers?
Yeah.
I remember you guys did it. That's right. I didn't see the results, but I remember they did that. Very good. And this is one I actually took a lot of time to do as well. There's another one I saw you guys writing. I think that was a reptile. You guys were writing all along for reptiles, weren't you? Tanner was?
Who was?
What was that mirror patch you were doing? That wildlife thing? That he had to go out and homework.
But it wasn't making an essay or anything.
It just a lot of homework.
Yeah.
Again, this is one of the harder ones. They just got to start it when they get up there that day and they can watch their little bias for as it's supposed to work. I know some of them. Did yours bug live?
Mine, I think, might have lived the longest. But that's like a day behind these guys. So it's like, no one expected to live that long, so.
Okay. All right. But the idea was to have a plastic bottle, they covered it with plastic, and they made their own biosphere. They put plants in there, and the plants were supposed to produce the oxygen and keep that little bug they had in there alive. But all they could find was bees, so the bees seemed to all die in there. So. But it was a lot of work, actually, so congratulations, guys, and have a seat. Very good. You got the rank of star. And one more back. This one right here, huh? It's not very much, but we're going to let Joshua read this. Joshua, we're bringing your sprite, buddy. Joshua's going to read the requirements for star rank, and then we'll tell you who it is. But move up a little bit so that these people in the audience can hear you, and we'll go from there.
You should be patrol for at least 4 months as a first class scout. Demonstrate scout point. Rank number two. Requirement. Demonstrate scout spirit by living the scout oath, the scout law, in your everyday life. Number three. Earn 6 merit badges, including any 4 in the required list for evil. Number four. While a first class scout, take part in a service project totaling at least 6 hours of work. These projects must be approved by your scoutmaster. Number five, while a first class scout, serve actively for 4 months in one or more of the following positions of responsibility, or carry out the scoutmaster assigned leadership project to help the troop.
No, that's fine. No, use your position.
Number six, take part in a scoutmaster conference. And number seven, complete your board work.
Very good. There are two young men who've been working hard. I'm up here serving with.
Jeff Vassapoli and Kenny Esteban.
Wow. Thank you so much, Jim and Bronwyn. Come up here, please. And as you're doing that, and Kenny, Bronwyn, come on here, Jeff, you help her. Come here, come over here. Come on. Okay, then sit right there. Come on. Come over, Kenny. Take that little pin off and pin on your mom's lapel there somewhere and her collar there somewhere. Come step right here. Because obviously, you know, you want to come up here because this is obviously a family or group effort. You know, we say we try to come here and have our boys come this, have this advancement through the scouts, and yes, we try to do it, but, you know, it's at home pushing these boys to get this stuff done sometimes. You know, we got to encourage these kids. You got to bring them to the meetings. You know, my son just as well come up just to make excuses. I got a lot of homework. I got a lot of this, but, you know, we got to get them out here. That's just part of homework, part of schoolwork, part of what your commitments are for the week. Come out here on Tuesdays. We know when the meetings are, so let's get our boys out here so they can advance. Star is, you know, up after star is life, and after life is eagle, okay? 2 more ranks after that. Most of these require some time commitment, and actually being some commitment to do some of the major or more, and I wouldn't say difficult, more of the merit badges that require a little more of these boys to make phone calls on their own. That's what's going on here now. The parents got to push these boys to make phone calls on their own to get merit badge counselors and that type of thing. And as well, us as parents can be merit badge counselors as well. So that's kind of another next push we need to make for our scouts is for some of us parents to be counselors for merit badges. And that'll be one of our next things we talk about soon. Anyways, great job, guys. Thank you for encouraging these young men to come out here. It's a very important rank. That's a nice step for them. 2 more ranks to go. And make our eagle rank, okay? But that takes a little bit of time as well, another year or so, year and a half or so to get that done. So If you would, you guys, stand up, please. Boy Scouts. Scouts new. Two. Congratulations, guys.
Take their own smart beverage.
He had to visit a national, building of some sort of special purpose, like the Coast Guard facility. Special traits of other countries, what they specialize in economic wise.
What about you, Kenny?
You have to really know what's part of being citizenship on how to become one, and you learn about the currency exchange rates.
Jeffrey? You also learn about the different political parties like fascist, communist, democracy.
Tanner, anything about it?
We have to take at least 1 year of
foreign
language.
Awesome. Good job.
Peter Van Kubrick and Jeffrey Vassapoli. And can Peter tell me what you had to do to get this?
We had to run a mile or run for 9 minutes for time. Had to keep our bodies fit and keep record of that for 3 months. That took a lot of work.
And Jeffrey, anything about it?
We each had to take a test for different periods during the 3 month time that we had to keep our log.
Okay. Tanner? Yeah.
Just keep track of stuff.
That was our response. All right, good.
talk about the safety at home, like if we need to know like a fire escape route, or we also needed to there was a checklist that we had to go through to see if our house was safe enough.
We had to collect a few newspaper articles that are common accidents at home and like traffic accidents.
Good job.